How's it going, guys? I'm here to review Bad Moon 1996.
A house on the edge of the woods.
Out here it's safe and peaceful.
A family alone.
So Bad Moon is a late 90s werewolf film that a lot of people actually never seen or never heard of. So this movie is pretty much an underrated horror gem. So the film begins with a couple in the jungle with a bunch of natives, with a bunch of villagers. And they decide to have sex in a tent, and because they're exploring something, if you know what I mean. But of course, the whole campsite with the villagers gets killed by a mysterious beast. So one by one, they get killed off while the couple's having sex in the tent. And of course, they get interrupted. The chick is on top of the dude, and then she gets grabbed by a werewolf from behind. So basically, the werewolf rips through the tent. She gets grabbed. She gets fucking bitten. She gets killed. The guy gets the shotgun. He gets scratched and bitten along the way. Shoots the werewolf's head off. Blows that motherfucker's head off, I should say. And he survives. But now he has the curse because he's infected with the werewolf scratch. Now he will become the werewolf when the full moon strikes. Later on in the movie, he then contacts his sister. The sister's a mother of a kid, of a son, and she's a single mother. They have a dog named Thor. Thor is pretty much the main protagonist in this movie. He is like the definition of a true, like, loyal dog in this movie. Thor is the goat. And this movie is actually based off of a novel called Thor, so that's nice to know. And I heard the novel is basically like, it's like Stephen King's Rear Window, but a dog version. Like, the dog is seeing all this weird, spooky, supernatural shit across the window, the door. But of course, nobody believes Thor because he's a dog. Anyways, Uncle Ted, that's his name. He is Uncle Ted. He talks to his sister. He talks to his nephew to see, you know, like, what they've been up to. And of course, Thor doesn't trust him because he smells that scent off of Ted. So, of course, Thor doesn't trust him because Ted's a werewolf. Eventually, later on, the sister insists that she can stay with, or that he can stay with her. And so he moves his RV, his trailer, car, vehicle, his home, pretty much, the backyard of her house. And that's when things starts to build up. So Thor keeps going to Uncle Ted's RV and pretty much just stares him down. And Ted knows that the dog knows, and that's when they have a little battle, a little conflict. There's this one scene where Ted actually turns into a werewolf, and it was fucking epic. Thor actually battles the werewolf, so it was like a dog versus werewolf fight, which is really cool. And I love Thor because he will do anything. He's a loyal dog to protect his family, which is really cool. And it's a German Shepherd, too.
A favorite uncle who needed their help.
Things haven't been going so good for me since I got back, sis.
You could come stay with us.
But when they invited him in...
Think I better keep my eye on you.
They let in something they could never imagine. Or ever.
But of course, when officials and cops and investigators, when they see dead bodies of other random strangers across the woods near the sister's house, they then decide to blame the dog because it has animal marks and biting wounds. So of course they wouldn't believe it's a werewolf, but they think like it would be Thor because only a dog would do that, such a thing. So they take Thor away to the pound or whatever. They basically take the dog away from them, and it's pretty sad. It's a really sad scene because even the kid was crying, the mother was crying, everybody was crying, tears. So it was a sad scene. And of course, Ted's an asshole. He's like, the kid goes on a Stranger Things adventure. He goes on his bike to free the dog, to go on like a risky adventure. Frees the dog while the mother is meanwhile getting attacked by the werewolf. Thor saves the mother. Thor attacks the werewolf. They have a little fight, a bloody battle, I should say. And yeah, that's all I can say. I don't want to spoil the rest of the ending and the rest of the movie, but it's a pretty damn good movie. It's one of those cheesy 90s horror films that it's so cheesy, but it's so good. And then everything just works in this movie, in my opinion. Like, this movie has everything. It has soul, it has heart, it has drama, it has blood, it has gore, it has cursing, it has sweaty sex. It has everything in this movie. Even it has like a 90s, like a little kid's movie nostalgia, if that makes sense. I can compare The Son to like one of those kids in The Sandlot. Like, that's a 90s movie too. So that was by far the worst explanation. I compare this, like, it has like a Goonies and Stranger Things feel because of The Son trying to do like adventures, trying to rescue his dog. That's what I'm trying to say, but more of a like a 90s Sandlot feel, if that makes sense. The special effects in this movie is really amazing. Like, even the animatronics and the special effects for the actual werewolf, really cool. I really love the werewolf design in this movie. The werewolf looks badass in this movie, and the characters are good. The dialogue is well written. This, like I said, the special effects is good. My favorite character is honestly not a human. It's actually the dog itself, the German Shepherd Thor. He's pretty much one of the best horror protagonists, like, ever. There's really nothing I could say about this movie. This movie is just good. And one more thing to say. If you guys haven't seen it, it is pretty hard to find. I recommend watching this on Tubi. It should be on Tubi. Or if not, just buy a Blu-ray Scream Shout Factory version of it. They have both versions. They have the original version. They have the unrated version, which is the NC-17 version at the time. So I enjoyed this movie very well, even though it had some flaws still. Like, it had some cheesy moments, but it was still good. So I would rate this movie a 7.9 out of 10. It was a really enjoyable movie and one of the best werewolf movies I've seen in a long time. And it's really, really different. It's a different take on your average werewolf movie too. So highly recommend this movie if you guys haven't seen it. It's one of those underrated horror gems. So that was my quick review of Bad Movie 1996. Please leave a comment, leave a like, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Yeah.